Yes, no, not you. Yeah, you think you take your red coat off, I don't recognize you. Nice try. Here's someone with a red coat, I think I'll ask them a question.
Oh my god!
Oh, you know I love that kid, I'm just messing with him. I tell you what, let's do. Can we do something? Are you going to come to the autograph session later? I hope you will. Okay, let's do it then. Let's do it then, because I want to make sure I get to as many questions as possible. Okay, babe? Thank you. Yes?
Is this a pair of pants?
So adds more interesting because of what his life experience is. Tommy, he's so dang beautiful. Those purple eyes, oh my gosh. I want to get, I'm such a nerd, you guys. I'm going to confess to you, I actually wanted to get purple contacts. I wanted to go out. And I, who gets to have purple eyes? Damn, Coleman. I want to have purple eyes. So, I didn't. I fought the urge, and I didn't do it, but I wanted to. Yes. Hey, Usa-chan. Does that have anything to do with my pants?
Thank you.
brag about being the girl that licked my hand. Like, sweetheart, that's nothing to brag about. You don't tell people. They're gonna run away from you. If only I had a hand like this, huh? That would have been awesome. She had a big tongue full of fur. That'd be awesome. You have a question?
What is the most unique experience you've had in your career as a voice actor?
Most unique experience. Oh my gosh. Wow. I've had many. It's hard even to zero in on one because I had so many. Unique experience. I can tell you this, that I'm very, very grateful that I've had the chance to meet some personal heroes of mine. Like William Shatner. Now, I want you guys to imagine something with me. Imagine little scrawny Vic Mignogna at 12 years old, right? 13 years old, this big around, wearing a Star Trek uniform that he made, right? And going to Star Trek conventions, dressed as Captain Kirk. Now, I did that. I would go to conventions, and I met Leonard Nimoy. I met DeForest Kelly, who played Dr. McCoy. I met Jimmy Dewitt, who played Scotty. I met George Takei, who played Sulu. I met Nichelle Nichols, who played Uhura. I met Walter Koenig, who played Chekhov. And the only one I never met was Bill Shatner. He just was never at any of the conventions that I went to. He wasn't there. Then these other guests, just like here, you know, you have some guests and others aren't here. Maybe they'll be here next year, maybe not, but I never got to meet William Shatner. And he was my favorite. Fast forward all these decades, when I started voice acting, I had no clue in the world that it would ever end up being what it has become in my life. Not just getting to do all these great shows and play these characters, he would go, sign it, and I would leave. And that would be my experience with William Shatner. But because of voice acting, I had dinner with him, I sat with him and literally told him, he came to me. I mean, I was signing autographs at the convention and his table was right beside mine. What? Like, I'm on this side of the table with you. The 12-year-old was going crazy inside. Right? I'm cool. I'm an actor. I'm just an actor. Hi, Bill. How are you doing? Right? So we go into the green room, and we're sitting there, and he slides over and he goes, tell me about him. Foreman welcomes him. I can go to heaven right now. How much better does that get? Can you pretend to be me? Like 12-year-old me? Can you imagine? I'm telling him the story. He's putting his hand on my forearm. And he's going, really? That's amazing. I'm looking into the eyes of this man that meant so much to me when I was young. In a way that I would have never, ever, ever, ever gotten close to him, to have that kind of personal connection. What a gift. I would have never believed in a million years that that would ever be an opportunity like that. So the answer to the question is, number one, getting to meet all of you and interact with all of you. You'll never know how much that means to me. And the second one is to get to meet people like that that had such a big influence on me and that I would have otherwise never done. Hey, you want to do something fun? Yeah. I want to do something fun. I put this DVD in here, and I haven't done anything with it, but let's do something fun.
Oh, boy.
When I was little,